Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining us. I am Rector Omar Reyes of Church of Christ Albertville. Before we begin our actual morning service, I wanted us to sing a hymn, "The Church is One Foundation." So let's begin with that. Wasn't that beautiful? I love that hymn. Let us begin. The hour is coming, and now is, when the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth, for such the Father seeks to worship him. John 4:23. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and humbly repent for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ. Have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways through the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. Lord, open our lips, and our mouths shall proclaim your praise. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Come, let us adore him. And now let us say the Veniti, Psalm 95, 1 through 7. Come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and raise a loud shout to him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hands are the caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are also his. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands have molded the dry land. Come, let us bow down and bend the knee and kneel before the Lord our Master, for he is our God. And we are the people of his pasture, the sheep of his hand. Oh, that today you would hearken to his voice. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. And now the appointed Psalm 13. How long, O Lord, will you forget me forever? How long will you hide your face from me? How long must I bear pain in my soul and have sorrow in my heart all day long? How long shall my enemies be exalted over me? Consider and answer me, O Lord my God. Give light to my eyes, or I will sleep the sleep of death. And my enemies shall say, I have prevailed. My foes will rejoice because I am shaken. But I trusted in your steadfast love. My heart shall rejoice in your salvation. I will sing to the Lord because he has dealt bountifully with me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. And now the first lesson. After these things, God tested Abraham, and he said to him, Abraham. And Abraham said, here am I. And he said, take your son, your only son Isaac, whom you love, and go to the land of Moriah and offer him there as a burnt offering on one of the mountains I shall show you. So Abraham rose early in the morning, saddled his donkey, and took two of his young men with him and his son Isaac. He cut the wood for the burnt offering and set out and went to the place in the distance that God had shown him. On the third day, Abraham looked up and saw the place far away. Then Abraham said to his young men, stay here with the donkey, and the boy and I will go over there. We will worship, and then we will come back to you. Abraham took the wood of the burnt offering and laid it on his son Isaac, and he himself carried the fire and the knife. So the two of them walked on together. And Isaac said to his father Abraham, Father. And he said, Here I am, my son. And he said, The fire and the wood are here, but where is the lamb for the burnt offering? Abraham said, God will provide the lamb for the burnt offering, my son. And the two of them walked on together. Then they came to the place that God shown him. Abraham built an altar there and laid the wood in order. He bound his son Isaac and laid him on top of the altar on top of the wood. Then Abraham reached out his hand and took the knife to kill his son. But the angel of the Lord called to him from heaven and said, Abraham, Abraham. And he said, Here I am. And he said, Do not lay your hand on the boy or do anything to him, for now I know you fear God, since you have not withheld your son, your only son, from me. And Abraham looked up and saw the ram caught in the thicket by its horns. Abraham went, took the ram, and offered it up as a burnt offering instead of his son. So Abraham called that place, The Lord Will Provide. As it is said to this day, Go. On the mount of the Lord, it shall be provided. The word of the Lord. And now Canticle 9, the first song of Isaiah. Surely it is God who saves me. I will trust in him and not be afraid. For the Lord is my stronghold and my sure defense. He will be my savior. Therefore, you shall draw waters with rejoicing from the spring of salvation. And on that day, you shall say, Give thanks to the Lord and call upon his name. Make his deeds known among the people. See that they remember that his name is exalted. Sing the praises of the Lord, for he has done great things. And this is known in all the world. Cry aloud, inhabitants of Zion. Ring out your joy. For the great one is in the midst of you. For the great one in the midst of you is the Holy One of Israel. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Our second reading is from Romans 6. Therefore, do not let sin exercise dominion in your mortal bodies, to make you obey their passions. No longer present your members to sin as instruments of wickedness, but present yourselves to God as those who have been brought from death to life, and present your members as to God as instruments of righteousness. For sin will have no dominion over you, since you are not under the law but under grace. What then, should we sin because we are not under the law, but under grace? By no means. Do you not know that if you present yourselves to anyone as obedient slaves, you are slaves to the one whom you obey, either of sin, which leads to death, or of obedience, which leads to righteousness? But thanks be to God that you, having once been slaves to sin, have become obedient from the heart to the form of teaching to which you are entrusted, and that you, having been set free from sin, have become slaves to righteousness. I am speaking in human terms because of your natural limitations, for just as you once presented your members as slaves to impurity and to greater and greater iniquity, so now present your members as slaves to righteousness for sanctification. When you were slaves of sin, you were free in regard to righteousness. So what advantage did you get from the things which now you are ashamed? The end of those things are death. But now you have been freed from sin and enslaved to God. The advantage you get is sanctification. The end is eternal life. For the wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. And now Canticle 13, a song of praise. Glory to you, God of our fathers. You are worthy of praise. Glory to you. Glory to you for the radiance of your holy name. We will praise you and highly exalt you forever. Glory to you in the splendor of your temple, on the throne of your majesty. Glory to you. Glory to you seated between the cherubims. We will praise you and highly exalt you forever. Glory to you beholding the depths and the high vaults of heaven. Glory to you. Glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We will praise you and highly exalt you forever. And now a reading from the Gospel, Matthew chapter 10. Whoever welcomes you welcomes me, and whoever welcomes me welcomes the one who sent me. Whoever welcomes a prophet in the name of a prophet will receive a prophet's reward. Whoever welcomes a righteous person in the name of a righteous person will receive a reward of the righteous. And whoever gives even a cup of cold water to one of these little ones in the name of a disciple, truly I tell you, none of these will lose their reward. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And now, let us say the Apostles' Creed together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again and ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And now Suffrage A, on page 97 of your Book of Common Prayer, if you're following us there. Show us your mercy, O Lord, and grant us your salvation. Clothe your ministers in righteousness. Let your people sing with joy. Give peace, O Lord, in all the world, for only in you can we live in safety. Lord, keep this nation under your care and guide us in the ways of justice and truth. Let your ways be known upon the earth, your saving health among all nations. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and sustain us with your Holy Spirit. O God, whose blessed Son made himself known to his disciples in the breaking of bread, open the eyes of our faith that we may behold him in all his redeeming work, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Almighty and everlasting God, by whom the spirits of the whole body of your faithful people is governed and sanctified, receive our supplications and prayers, which we offer before you, for all the members of your holy church, that in their vocation and ministry they may truly and devoutly serve you, through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. And before we offer the peace, if you have any prayers that you want us to pray about, please, write them. I know we're doing Facebook Live, so you can write your prayer requests. Or go to our website. We have a section where you can submit prayer requests. Let us take a few moments to pray for our needs and needs of others. Lord, again, we thank you for answering our prayers as best fits us. Now, as we enter this time of offering, I pray that you will look upon your church, that you will stir their gratitude and their generosity to provide for the works of the church as you have before. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you and also with you. So greet each other. If you're with someone, greet them. If you're on video, wave to each other. And as we do our offertory hymn, I want you to think about all the things that God has done for you in a positive way. What do I mean by that? Sometimes we get caught up in all the negativity of this world, but we have to remember that God is working in us and God is doing good things for us. You woke up this morning. Hopefully you have a refrigerator with some food in it. Think about those things and thank God for the things that he's provided for you. Again, thank you for your generosity. If you want to give, you can. You can click on the button on our website, or you can mail it in. But please, by all means, don't forget the pledges you've made and all the good things we're doing for it, our beans and rice ministry. I just had someone last week ask for the church to help them with their water bill. And we were able to do that. It's those things that we're made for. This is what we do. We help people in need. So let us continue with the general thanksgiving. The general thanksgiving. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ. For the means of grace and for the hope of glory, we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise not only with our lips but with our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all of our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Now the prayer of St. Chrysostom's. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth in the age to come, everlasting life. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And again, thank you for coming. Also, thank all of you who tuned in yesterday to see our new bishop elected. It was a wonderful time of fellowship. And we pray for her and we pray for, you know, our old bishop as they walk together. And he helps her, you know, I guess learn the process of being a bishop. But we were very thankful for those of you who tuned in. And I want to thank you guys for tuning in. And hopefully we will be meeting in our drive-in service next week. But if weather doesn't permit, we'll be right here on the internet again. So tell your friends, share. Some of you are wondering probably what happened to the sermon. I taped the sermon separately to keep the service a little shorter, but it's already posted up so you can see that sermon whenever you're ready. And again, thank you and God bless you for joining us here at Christ Episcopal Church, Albertville.
Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Pardon for sin and a peace that endureth, thine own dear presence to cheer and to guide. Strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow. Blessings are mine with 10,000.